Imagine a battlefield where the enemy is left blind, deaf, and disorientated, radars jammed, communications severed, and sophisticated electronic systems reduced to useless hardware. Precision-guided missiles lose their targets, and commanders are unable to coordinate their troops. What force could achieve such dominance? The answer lies in the world of electronic warfare, embodied by the formidable EA-18G Growler. This cutting-edge aircraft is designed to take control of the electromagnetic spectrum, rendering enemy defenses ineffective. By jamming radars, disrupting communications, and neutralizing enemy sensors, the Growler ensures that friendly forces can move undetected and strike with precision. It doesn't just suppress threats, it rewrites the rules of engagement, turning the enemy's reliance on technology into a liability. Controlling the electromagnetic spectrum, or EMS, has become a decisive factor in modern warfare, directly influencing the success of both offensive and defensive operations. Military forces rely heavily on communication networks, radar systems, satellite links, and guided weapons, most of which are vulnerable to interference through electronic warfare, or EW. Command and control depend on secure and uninterrupted access to the EMS, and disrupting an enemy's use of it can render their operations ineffective by jamming communication channels, disabling radars, and misleading guided weapons. Dominating the EMS also allows for critical operations such as suppression of enemy air defenses, or SEAD, where electronic attack aircraft jam enemy radars and blind surface-to-air missile systems. Without such control, modern militaries would find themselves at the mercy of adversaries capable of blocking communications, disrupting coordination, and launching precision-guided attacks without warning. Additionally, in asymmetric warfare, electromagnetic superiority is essential to counter unmanned systems, intercept signals intelligence, and protect networks from cyber attacks. As technology advances, electromagnetic spectrum operations, or EMSO, are increasingly integrated with cyber capabilities, making EMS control essential for maintaining both information dominance and battlefield situational awareness. In future conflicts, where the lines between kinetic and electronic warfare continue to blur, the ability to control or deny access to the electromagnetic spectrum will likely determine the outcome of battles and ensure operational success. The story of the Growler began in the early 2000s. As the US Navy's EA-6B Prowler fleet, which had been in service since 1971, started showing signs of age and fatigue, a replacement was needed. Thus, the call for a new, more capable electronic attack aircraft was made. In 2003, the Navy awarded Boeing a 5-year system development and demonstration contract to build this next-generation airborne electronic attack aircraft. By July 2006, the first 4 production units had been ordered, and the first test flight took place in August of that same year. Later in the fall, the first 2 test aircraft were delivered to the US Navy. The aircraft proved its worth in the trials, and by 2009, it had achieved its initial operational capability, ready to replace the Prowler. The Growler, based on the proven FA-18F Super Hornet, was more than just a derivative. It was an evolution. The dimensions of the Growler reflect its expanded capabilities. It has a maximum takeoff weight of 66,000 pounds and a carrier landing weight of 48,000 pounds, an increase of nearly 3,000 pounds compared to the FA-18F. This increase in weight is largely due to the integration of advanced avionics and mission systems, transforming the aircraft into a formidable tool of warfare. The EA-18G Growler is powered by two F414 GE400 afterburning turbofan engines from General Electric. These engines collectively provide an impressive 44,000 pounds of thrust. With this power, the Growler can reach a maximum speed of over 1,200 miles per hour, or Mach 1.6. When equipped with external fuel tanks, the Growler boasts a range of over 975 miles without requiring aerial refueling, giving it the ability to stay on station for a prolonged period. The cockpit of the Growler is a high-tech space where the pilot and electronic warfare officer work in tandem to operate the aircraft's systems. The cockpit features four 8x10-inch liquid crystal displays and upfront control panel. The pilot and electronic warfare officer have identical 8x10-inch displays, which provide a larger and clearer picture of the battle situation. The aircraft is also fitted with a joint helmet-mounted cueing system, allowing the pilot to aim sensors and weapons wherever they're looking. The electronic warfare suite of the Growler is its true power center. Initially, the suite included up to three ANALQ-99 radar jamming pods, an ANALQ-218V2 receiver, and a Raytheon ANALQ-227 communications countermeasures set. The ANALQ-99 jamming pods cover a wide frequency of range and can disrupt multiple frequency points simultaneously. The ANALQ-218V2 receiver, in combination with the jamming pods, provides a selective reactive jamming capability and geolocation of emitters. The ANALQ-227 system, on the other hand, provides integrated information from onboard and offboard sources to optimize the electronic warfare effects. This suite is rounded off by the ANAPG-79AESA radar system, which can function in air-to-air and air-to-surface modes while providing high-resolution synthetic aperture radar mapping. These systems are continuously updated, keeping the Growler at the forefront of electronic warfare. For instance, the next-generation jammer mid-band system, which is currently being integrated, will replace the legendary ANALQ-99 tactical jamming system. This new system will provide improved airborne electronic attack capabilities to disrupt and degrade enemy air defense and ground communication systems. One unique aspect of the Growler's capabilities is that when three Growlers are networked together, they can generate targeting tracks for hostile radio frequency sources in real time. Utilizing data links, the Growler can use its electronic warfare pods to accurately locate signal sources. When one aircraft detects a signal from a source, such as a cell phone, the other two can also listen for the same signal. Each measures the amount of time taken for transmissions to travel from the source to each aircraft, trilaterating the location to an extremely precise area. Despite its electronic warfare prowess, the EA-18G Growler is no slouch when it comes to conventional warfare. The Growler can carry AIM 120 AMRAAM and AIM 9X Sidewinder missiles for self-defense, and is equipped with an M61A1 20mm cannon. The aircraft can also carry AGM-88 high-speed anti-radiation missiles, or HARM, and the advanced AGM-88E Advanced Anti-Radiation Guided Missile, or AARGM, both designed to target enemy radar systems. The EA-18G Growler is undergoing significant upgrades to maintain its edge in electronic warfare as part of the Growler Capability Modification, or GCM, program. This multi-year effort is the first major enhancement to the aircraft since its introduction and aims to prepare the Growler for increasingly complex electromagnetic environments. Moreover, the GCM program introduces improvements to processing speed and electronic warfare algorithms, enabling the aircraft to counter more sophisticated threats. These advancements, combined with the aircraft's robust AESA radar and expanded data transfer capabilities, ensure that the Growler remains capable of supporting US and allied forces across various operations, including suppression of enemy air defenses, or SEAD. The upgrades are expected to be implemented across the fleet by 2029, ensuring that the Growler continues to dominate the electromagnetic spectrum well into the future. In sum, the EA-18G Growler is a true powerhouse in the realm of electronic warfare. With its cutting-edge technology and robust combat systems, it can effectively blind and silence an enemy, rendering their advanced systems useless. The Growler's unique capabilities make it an invaluable asset in modern warfare, where the ability to control the electromagnetic spectrum can often dictate the outcome of a battle. The Growler is, without doubt, a game-changer, and its place in the history of warfare is firmly established. This concludes our episode that provides a glimpse into the EA-18G Growler. So what do you think about this fascinating aircraft? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? Also, if you were lucky enough to see these aircraft up close, or better yet, fly one, please comment. Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.